I've been seeing a lot of accounts all over the world of mass demonic possessions, entire schools, these kids manifesting demons, and I've been hearing stories of people dying during exorcisms. So I want to explain how not to cast out a demon. One, you don't beat them. You don't starve them to death. You don't sit on them. It's insanity. But some more subtle things that are happening. We know the Word of God is the sword of the Spirit. The Word of God, the gospel of grace through love, should be preached to free these people. It's the authority and the power of Jesus' name. It's not just his name. It's not a magic word. You could see the seven exorcists that were attacked by the demon and stripped naked. They weren't in Christ. They themselves weren't saved. They didn't believe on him. They just knew his name worked to cast demons out, and the demons knew it. So they attacked them. They had no authority, no power. So one of the things I've been seeing, I'm sorry, Chris LaSala, I'm not trying to be mean, but I have to say this. I saw Chris LaSala cast out a demon out of a street preacher or something. Anyway, somebody that's literally saved by grace through faith alone, their spirit's reborn, and a demon can't live in that body. They can oppress them, but they can't possess them. So I want to clear that up. If you're truly saved, you'll see a lot of Catholics that are possessed, but they believe in a work salvation, and we know that adding anything to the gospel negates salvation, because grace is of none effect to them, because they haven't rested in the finished work of Christ, his blood atonement on us. So what I heard him do is literally carry on conversation with a supposed demon. And he even said, never seen a real Christian before, huh? I never seen anybody have real power like me. And I'm like, pride much? I first of all, they lie. Why are you talking to them to feed your ego? What? It's not your power. It's God's power. And why do you need a demon to validate whether you have God's power or not? Just believe it. I would recommend, and I've done this in houses. I haven't done it on a person. But the Word of God, you know, to stand on that. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers, rulers of darkness of this world, and spiritual wickedness in high places. Behold, I give you power to trample on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing by any means shall ever hurt you. This is what we need to be speaking over these people. I command you in the name and authority of Jesus Christ to leave this child of God. Get them out. You don't converse with them. The only time Jesus ever spoke to them was to ask their name, and I believe that was so he could show that there's more than one in there. He didn't do that every time. He knew which spirit was in him, but this guy in the tombs that was cutting himself and acting crazy, he knew he had thousands of demons in him, and that's why he said, "What's your name? Legion, for we are many." He didn't converse with them. He was very calm. They don't yell and call down, "Fire! Fire! Fire!" I don't know what all that is. The sword of the Spirit's the Word of God. You need to calmly speak the Word of God with authority and faith. And that's it. Now, there's some that are really powerful and know the loopholes and they don't want to stay. There's generational curses and that are passed down and so forth. But I just see, I saw one gentleman, a street preacher, absolutely cast one out. And all he did was preach the pure and simple gospel of grace through faith alone, not repenting of sins for the remission of sins. It's repent of unbelief and dead works unto faith, resting in the finished work of Christ, believing the blood of Jesus covers our sins, and we are now in right standing, justified to God by grace through faith, by being in his Son. If you can have that security, then you have the authority, and we're commanded to cast these out. TV has done so much. I don't believe in with a crucifix with an image of Jesus. Do not make any graven image of anything in heaven. I don't see how breaking a commandment can be used against evil. I don't know. I guess there's some lesser ones that hate the image of even thought of him, maybe that'll leave. But it's the Word of God and the authority and power, the dunamis, the power of God. That's what left Jesus when the woman touched the tassel on his tallit, the hem of his garment. That's what came out of him. Dunamis, the power that came out of him. He said, I felt virtue leave me. So it's all about the authority, the power, and the word of God. I don't understand. I don't even know about the holy water. I know that there's some instances in the Bible that Paul touched handkerchiefs or something, and those things healed. I think that was, he was just covered in the Holy Spirit, and it just, you know, worked because his faith was so strong. But as far as holy water and stuff, they do tell us to anoint people with oil for their healing. So sure, I don't see why we can't use you know, the olive oil that with the myrrh and frankincense that's mixed in Israel. I don't see why we can't use that. But it's literally the blood of Christ, the word of God, the power and authority that delivers people. And you want to get them saved once the demon's been cast out. You want to tell them the true gospel. You trust in Christ alone, and you want to instruct them to really dive into the word of God and grow close to God once they're saved by grace through faith, to keep them from entering, because Jesus warns us that once the house is swept clean, if nothing else is inhabiting that body, they will come back with them plus some of their buddies. So we want to make sure that the Holy Spirit dwells within them once they're cast out. The gentleman I saw cast one out, he just preached the clear word of God, took power and authority over it very calmly. The man coughed up a little and he spit a little bit, and he was like, whoa, I'm free. Like, it was that simple. There's some that come out by prayer and fasting. You know, he said that. Gotta remember, that was before the resurrection. So now that we're under the blood, there's no reason we have to beat people. And, you know, there's people dying from exorcism. This is crazy town. And it's just crazy what I'm seeing, you know, throwing holy water on them and showing them the crucifix. It's an image. I wouldn't use it. It's the word. The word is what delivers people. The truth sets you free. You shall know the truth, and the truth will make you free. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. Where the Spirit of God is, there's freedom. Trust in that. Trust in His word. Use the word, your power and authority. I wouldn't recommend going in there if you believe in some false works-based gospel, because they're going to know you're not saved and attack you. There are people that aren't saved that are casting out demons. We know that from the depart from me, I never knew you verse. Didn't we do this? Didn't we cast out demons? Didn't we preach? Did we do great and mighty works in your name? Depart from me, worker of iniquity, I never knew you. They brought their works. They didn't rest in what Christ did alone. I did a couple videos, a parable on how the blood saves us. I explain willful sin, and those who are born of God don't commit willful sin. That's being taken out of context. That's because our spirit's reborn. We no longer sin. Paul said it's no longer me that sins, but the sin that dwells in me. So I hope that clears it up. And I'd like to see some real men of God out there very calmly in authority and power speak the word of God until those suckers leave. Okay. Bye.